Our Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2617, Python custom function. Actually, a couple of titles. How many times does this word occur in that long transcript? Or, hey, not so fast there, Sparky. Excel labs can already do this better than Python. All right, today's question.
Mr. Excel, easy question for you today. I have an entire season of Seinfeld scripts in Excel. I want to count the number of times any word appears, like Fred, or soup, or suit. Can we do this?
Today's question. We have a phrase up here, and I have a word, and I want to know how many times this word occurs in this phrase. Now, in this case, it's easy. Boot, boots, boot, three times. But to solve this in Excel, well, hey, yeah, it's super simple and super obvious. It's just five steps, all right? So step number one, we take the first phrase, B3, and substitute every occurrence of the word before with nothing, quote, quote. And so you see that gets rid of all occurrences of boot from the first phrase. Yep, I know, you're trying to count. Just bear with me. All right, then second thing we do is we figure out the length of the phrase before we did anything to it. It was 61. And then the length of the phrase after we removed the word boot three times, and it was 49. So how much did it change? 61 minus 49 is 12. The word that we removed, how long is it? So in this case, boot is four characters. That's the length of B4. And then to get the word count, finally our answer is we take that 12 and we divide it by the length of the word we removed, and that tells us how many occurrences there were. Now, of course, you wouldn't go through all of those steps if it was just this phrase. You would just look at it, you know, but like here I have a phrase that's 12,000 characters. It's a transcript from one of the podcasts. I'm gonna know how many times I said Excel, and it comes up with 10 times. Or if I look for Python, it comes up with 13 times, right? So it's a great, useful, simple formula you just knock out.
Are you crazy, Mr. Excel? How can any normal human figure that out? I see everyone is talking about Python in Excel. Is it easier?
Let's take a look at how Python would do this. They have a function called count that operates on a data frame, and you just say, I want to count the number of times this word occurred. So here's our data frame, XLD2, and we do the count of boot, and the answer is 3. Wow, that's really simple. Okay, so since it's so much simpler to do this in Python than Excel, can we build sort of a custom Python function? All right, so here's what I've done back here on this sheet. I have up in cell A1, the definition of a function. And I've added a little bit of extra stuff in that I take the lower of the text that's coming in and then do a count of which word. So we're basically taking the original data frame, adding a new column called word count, and then we need to know which column. So in this case, it's the column called transcript, and then apply this function to take the lower and then count. Right? The function itself actually ends here with return df. If I just had that in cell A1, I'm not sure that we would get anything. It would just be a zero or blank. So there's this great trick that everyone is using to add a new last line to the formula. And that last line explains what's happening. You know, there's something in the cell. Don't just delete the cell or delete this column. And in my case, I originally had function loaded. But I said, well, wait a second, wouldn't it be nice if I actually documented it? The function's called this word count. I have to pass it a data frame, the column name, and which word I'm looking for. Right, cool. So that's kind of my definition of the custom Python function. And then down here is my input cell. That's the which word. Here's the list of transcripts from several different podcast episodes. And right here, it's one line of code. So we call the function name, this word count. We have to pass it a data frame. So that's XL A8 to B16, headers equals true. You know, I could even do this. B8 to B16, I don't have to specify the whole thing. And then which column? It's the column called transcript, and which word we want to produce, Excel. Now, we're going to talk about this word count. There was a lot of beating my head against the wall to get this to work, but let's just take a look here. I'll do Control Enter, and there's our answer. And now if we change it from Excel to Python, yeah, it's pretty fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we actually did a little test here with the console. I want to know, is it calling this function once for each of the rows, or is it calling it just once for the whole thing? So I did something like this. I added a line called print calling function. Now print is used a lot in regular Python, and it returns something to the console. Here in Excel, it's returning something to the diagnostics tab. All right, so if I change from Python to Excel, I will see that there is a fresh call right there. Right, so it's efficient. It's just calling the thing once. It operates on the whole data frame and returns those answers. All right, a couple things we discovered. Originally, I had this as a table, Ctrl+T, and just like dynamic arrays don't work well with tables, these Python formulas don't work well with tables. It actually wiped out my formula. It just changed it to a zero. It was like, nope, not going to allow you to do that. And then the other thing that drove me insane is I knew that I had transcript and word count in the result. And so I didn't want to get that. Check this out. See, I get transcript again. And I'm like, I don't need the transcript again. And there were many, many times where I came here and said that I wanted just word count. Like that, Control Enter, and it drove me freaking insane that every time it was adding an index. I went out and Googled how to remove the index in Python, and it had three different formulas, and none of those formulas worked here. Excel would turn the data sideways, and it was changing it to a string instead of a number, and just drove me freaking insane. Thanks to Suat, who works here at Mr. Excel, for suggesting, hey, by having just one set of brackets, you're creating a series. Two sets of brackets will create a data frame. And sure enough, it worked, and there was much rejoicing. All right, now, here, I have to look at this. I'm still, every time I'm calling the function, I'm printing something over here, so I want to get rid of that. All right, good. And then Control Enter. All right, so there we go. We have something that is working in Python. Pretty cool little custom function up there, and then, you know, calling the function sort of like we would with a UDF. It'd be nice if we could name those parameters, maybe, and maybe you can, I don't know, but works pretty cool. Now, hey, just a lot of times here in these past few videos, people are like, well, wait, why are you doing this? Couldn't you have just done this in straight Excel? And, you know, a shout out here, of course we could do it in straight Excel with these formulas, but the Excel Labs folks over in Cambridge have just an amazing tool. So this is an add-in, you know, called Excel Labs. You go to Insert, Get It, Add-ins, and look for Excel Labs. And then out here on the far right-hand side of the Home tab, you'll have this Excel Labs button. We want to get into the Advanced Formula Environment. This is just some amazing functionality that's kind of buried in here. You want to click the second tab across the top, Names, and then this fourth icon is called Add Function from Grid. All right, so we've selected the system of formulas, click Add Function from Grid. They detect that the input cells are A17 and B17. The output cell is H17. When we click Preview, they use the headings from the row above in the let function. They create a lambda called ThisWordCount. We actually have to click Create and then click Save. And now this workbook, if we look in the name manager, has ThisWordCount defined. Right, and we can use it anywhere in the workbook. So test lambda equal this word count. It even asked me for the phrase, right? So that's cell B6 and the word. I'll press F4 on that one to lock it down. Double click to copy it down like that, right? And we change from Excel to Python. Works, we change to basic. Change to right. Oh, and hey, check this out. Can we call this just once? So B6 to B13 pass the whole set of phrases. Yes, that continues to work. I mean, let's face it, this lambda function is going to work in more places than the Python is going to work right now. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, thanks to Fred Stoller, staff writer at Seinfeld. Check out his book, My Seinfeld Year, available on Amazon.
Hello, Mr. Excel. I'm Fred Stoller. Maybe you know me as Fred Yerkes from Seinfeld. I also wrote the soup episode, not the soup Nazi. The soup counts as a meal.
If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Hey, here's a just a little outtake that documented why you can't do this next to a table. So, Ctrl+Shift+P to get into Python. This word, underscore count. And I'm going to point to the table. And we want the field called transcript. And the word is this one. Close the function, two left square brackets, word count. Control enter. All right, we get no results. The formula that we just entered is just gone. Just forget you. We're not even going to acknowledge your work. It just disappears. Said it a million times. Back in Excel 2007, they tried to put tables in. They realized it wasn't going to work. They wanted to take it out. It would be more work to take it out than to leave it in broken. So here we are. It's still broken. People ask me why I don't use tables. It's a feature that was never finished.